Good morning. Welcome to the Y Factor. The film that we are reviewing this week, Romeo, Akbar, Walter.
We are on the verge of a war with Pakistan.
बैंक मुझे कुछ महीनों के लिए बाहर भेज रहे हैं।
मेरी अम्मी का हमेशा ख्याल रखा जाए।
जंग जीती या हारी जाती है सिर्फ एक चीज के बेसिस पर। इंफॉर्मेशन।
तुम्हें एक अंडरकवर मिशन पर भेजा जा रहा है।
तुम एक हिंदुस्तानी एजेंट हो?
नहीं। बाहर निकलने के सारे रास्ते बंद हो चुके हैं।
Based on the story of an Indian spy. This film are one of those stories which needed to be said. John Abraham, as the protagonist, Romeo Ali, tries to put in his heart and soul for the film. Written and directed by Robbie Grewal, the film is brilliant in terms of its realism, in terms of the production value, in terms of the historical accuracy, in terms of not only the events that took place preceding the 71 war, but also in the authenticity of the era, the showing of Karachi, Liaquatabad, brilliant. Where it lacks is in terms of its weak screenplay. At a length of 2 hours and 20 minutes, it's too long for espionage thriller, especially in today's times. So that's where I feel Romeo could have done better. And Akbar Malik, like how Sikandar Khan nails the accent. John has a wide range of emotions which he could have displayed. Unfortunately, he is like a deer in the woods. Seems a little lost. For a first-time spy, at times he is shown as naive as one could be, but then things go as packed as filmy can be, which is where I feel the screenplay and the writing have let him down. Sikandar Khan in his cameo as an ISI cop is brilliant. Raghuveer Yadav is good. The supporting cast in the Pakistan area, very nice. On the contrary, it's these people who elevate the film to a certain extent and cover the mishaps of the poor writing. But somehow you keep yearning that something's amiss. Moni Roy seems such a misfit, not only as John's love interest, but even as the Indian diplomat. Sad. Like I said, because the film is so long in its writing that you never feel for any of the character. You don't feel for anyone. And that's why, in spite of having moments where it could be so thrilling, like an edge of the seat thriller, it's clunky, making you wait that when is Walter going to come. Walter, like we all discovered, comes towards not the fag end of the film, but literally at the end of the film. Leaving you wondering why couldn't they have thus named the film Akbar. But yeah, it does add a little layer to the film's multi-layered attempt. Leaving you with only Jackie Shroff as the head of RA&W, as the stylized head and the one with the best performance. These stories need to be told because India needs to know what its heroes have done for it, especially the unsung ones. Could they have been told better? I so wish. But still, they need to be told. For the lack of pure better writing and a very weak screenplay, I'm going with a 2 out of 5. And does it have the Y factor? No. Keep watching and do subscribe.